Hello, good morning. Good morning sa bawat isa. We welcome also those who are joining us via Facebook Live. Welcome to our Sunday School. So for those of us who are here, may I request everyone to stand so that we could begin in a word of prayer. Let us pray. Manalangin po tayo at ihanda natin ang ating mga puso at isipan sa mga ituturo sa atin ng Banal na Espiritu mula sa kanyang salita. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we come to you, Lord, as your children. We come to you praising you and thanking you for all the marvelous works that you have shown to us in our lives. And we thank you, Lord, for your Son, Jesus Christ, who died on the cross for our sins. For this time, we ask, Lord, that you forgive the sins that we have done. And we ask, Lord, that the Holy Spirit would guide us, would guide each heart that is listening, so that important truths would be imparted and applied. All these things I pray in the name of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. You may be seated. Turn to Acts chapter 20. Acts chapter 20 po ang magiging, ang babasahin natin sa araw na ito. There are times when you have to part with the people you love. May mga panahon na kailangan mong iwanan yung mga tao na minamahal mo. And before people part ways, you could always see them expressing some parting words to each other. Meron silang mga binibilin bago sila umalis. You can often see this kind of scenario in airports or in terminals, bus terminals. Diba? Kung saan nakikita nyo yung mga tao na bago nila iwan yung kanilang mga minamahal, ay may mga bilin sila. Example ng mga bilin ay alagaan mo mga kapatid mo, alagaan mo ang magulang mo, hindi po ba? Or huwag ka munang mag-girlfriend or boyfriend para sa mga bata. Para naman doon sa medyo tumatanda na, mag-asawa ka na. Yun ang mga bilin, di ba? Before parting from each other, we give these simple reminders and even simple instructions. The common premise is that these people would meet again someday. Why do people express their love and their concern to their loved ones, even though they know that they will still meet? Diba? It is because there will come a time na hindi na sila magkasama. And there is an uncertainty that they will still meet again. There is a chance that these people would not meet again. May mga times na yung mga tao na akala natin ay makikita pa natin, ay hindi na pala natin makikita muli. Now, if you are given a chance to give some parting words to your church, how would you address the church? Kung ikaw ay aalis na sa church, huwag naman sana kaagad, at kung ikaw ay alam mo na hindi na kayo magkikita ng church mo, ano sasabihin mo? What we're going to talk about today is how the Apostle Paul addressed the church leaders of Ephesus before he parts ways with them and before he ends up in Jerusalem and arrested. The title of our lesson is Final Loving Words for the Church of Christ. So sa Acts chapter 20, dito po natin makikita ang ating lesson. In our first heading, Paul resumes his missionary journey. Paul resumes his missionary journey. Sabay po natin basahin ang verse 1. And after the uproar was ceased, ito po yung pinag-usapan natin last week kung saan nagkaroon ng gulo sa Ephesus. After the uproar was ceased, Paul called unto him the disciples and embraced them and departed for to go into Macedonia. And when he had gone over those parts and had given them much exhortation, he came into Greece, and there abode 3 months. And when the Jews laid wait for him as he was about to sail into Syria, he purposed to return to Macedonia. And there accompanied him into Asia Sopater of Berea and of the Thessalonians, Aristarchus and Secundus, and Gaius of Derbe, and Timotheus and of Asia, Tychicus and Trophimus. These going before tarried for us at Troas. And we sailed away from Philippi after the days of unleavened bread and came unto them in Troas in 5 days, where we abode 7 days. So to summarize the verses that we have read, again, the Apostle Paul is continuing his missionary journey as the Holy Spirit leads him along with his companions. So mula sa Ephesus, ayan, makikita niyo yung mapa. Mula sa Ephesus, sa part ng Asia, sila ay dumiretso patungo doon sa Macedonia, patungo sa north. And eventually, bumaba sila patungo sa Greece. And then, when Paul decided to go to Syria, tatawid sila dyan sa Mediterranean Sea, papunta doon sa baba na part. Hindi sila natuloy because of the Jewish people who laid wait for the Apostle Paul. If we are going to remember, a lot of Jewish people were very angry with the words that came out of the Apostle Paul, with his message, and that is why they wanted to hurt him. So instead of proceeding to Syria because of this Jewish plot, the team, the missionary team, goes back to Macedonia, particularly dun sa Philippi, dun sa taas, and then tumawid sila papunta sa Troas. Okay, so yun yung summary ng mga verses na binasa natin. Masyado maraming pangalan at lugar, pero yun yung essence. Verse 7, and upon the first day of the week, when the disciples came together to break bread, Paul preached unto them, ready to depart on the morrow. And continued his speech until, take note of that, until midnight. So, si Apostle Paul ay nag-preach sa kanila, tinipon niya itong mga mananampalataya na nakinig sa kanya, at habang siya ay nagpipreach, umabot sila ng midnight. Verse 8, and there were many lights in the upper chamber where they were gathered together. And there sat in a window a certain young man named Eutychus, being fallen into a deep sleep, nakatulog. And as Paul was long preaching, he sunk down with sleep and fell down from the third loft and was taken up dead. And Paul went down and fell on him and embracing him said, trouble not yourselves, for his life is in him. When he therefore was come up again and had broken bread and eaten and talked a long while, even till break of day, so he departed. And they brought the young man alive and were not a little comforted. So again, the Apostle Paul talked to the believers and his preaching took until midnight. At dahil maaring matagal itong preaching ni Apostle Paul at yung mga tao ay pagod na, isa sa mga nakikinig, ang pangalan niya si Eutychus, ay nakatulog. At habang siya ay natutulog, habang nagpipreach si Apostle Paul, ay siya ay bumagsak at siya ay namatay sa kanya, mula sa kanyang pagkabagsak. We do not know how high his position was before falling. Maaring yun yung nakapag-cause ng kanyang pagkamatay, yung kanyang pagkabagsak. Di natin alam kung anong parts sa kanyang katawan yung nabali. Basta namatay siya dahil sa kanyang pagkabagsak. But God, through the Apostle Paul, allowed the healing and the coming to life of this young man named Eutychus. So, nabuhay siya. Oftentimes, this story is used as an illustration to scare the people. Diba, tinatakot nila yung mga tao, yung mga nakikinig, uy, huwag kayong matulog sa service, baka magaya kayo kay Eutychus. Diba? Naalala ko dati, may isang sa Sunday school, parang yun yung tinuturo sa kids. And even in some churches, this is still being propagated. Na yung lesson daw dito is huwag ka matutulog sa service. Now, yung iba, ginaganti nila sa preacher. Oh, preacher, huwag kang magpipreach hanggang midnight ha, baka may makatulog at baka matulad kay Eutychus. Okay? So again, this is a narrative and this is a narration of events that really happened. And we get to see here, not these people, but how God works through them. And when someone died during that night, it is God who allowed the miracle to happen. So we look to God for the lesson here in this narrative. Again, it is God who allows the healing. It is God who allows the miracles through the Apostle Paul. Particularly, the Apostle Paul was blessed with these miracles because these miracles allow the authentication of his message about Jesus Christ. So, nakita ng mga members yon at they were not a little comforted. Next heading, Paul meets with... basahin muna natin verse 13. Sorry, I skipped. So, what happened next? Verse 13, and we went before to ship and sailed unto Assos. there intending to take in Paul, for so had he appointed, minding himself to go afoot. Ginusto ni Apostle Paul na mag-travel by land. And when he met with us at Assos, we took him in and came into Mytilene, and we sailed thence and came the next day over against Chios. And the next day we arrived at Samos and tarried at Trogyllium, and the next day we came to Miletus. For Paul had determined to sail by Ephesus because he would not spend the time in Asia, for he hasted, if it were possible for him, to be at Jerusalem the day of Pentecost. And from Miletus, he sent to Ephesus and called the leaders of the church. So if you're going to imagine the map, can we have the map? If you have the map there. So the Apostle Paul, he was traveling around the area, as we understand. So he continued his travel from the regions where he has been, and he traveled there to Miletus. He did not go straight to Ephesus because he was trying to be at Jerusalem at a certain time. In other words, nagmamadali siya at ayaw niya na magdadaong pa sila doon sa Ephesus. So, nag-skip siya sa Ephesus and dumiretso siya doon sa Miletus. And from this place, he called for the Ephesian leaders. So, instead of going to Ephesus, pinatawag na lang niya na makipag-meet sa kanya yung mga leaders ng church ng Ephesus sa Miletus. Okay? So, our second heading, Paul meets with the Ephesian leaders. Verse 18. And when they were come to him, he said unto him, ye know from the first day that I came into Asia, after what manner I have been with you at all seasons, serving the Lord with all humility of mind, and with many tears and temptations, which befell me by the lying in wait of the Jews, and how I kept back nothing that was profitable unto you, but have showed you and have taught you publicly and from house to house, testifying both to the Jews and also to the Greeks, repentance toward God and faith toward our Lord Jesus Christ. So you could imagine here the Apostle Paul, na medyo siguro nang hina na siya at apektado niya yung kanyang kalusugan, yung kanyang physical appearance because of the numerous sufferings and afflictions that he has been through. So we could imagine that he is looking a little bit older than his actual age because of the stress that he has been through, because of the sufferings and the beatings and the imprisonment that he has been through, and he was talking to the Ephesian leaders. And with this in mind, si Apostle Paul, he has this idea that once he gets to Jerusalem, ay magiging katapusan na niya yun. At maaring hindi na niya makikita muli itong mga kinakausap niya. So anong sinabi niya? Kausap niya itong mga Ephesian leaders and he is recalling his ministry to them. Paul was not bragging about his life. Hindi niya pinagmamalaki yung kanyang accomplishments or yung kanyang pagmi-minister sa kanila. But rather, the Apostle Paul was emphasizing how the work of God was of utmost importance in his life. Ipinapakita niya dito kung gaano kahalaga yung pagsunod sa utos ng Diyos at paggawa ng gawain ng Diyos. Hindi siya nagmamalaki dito nung nire-recall niya sa mga Ephesian leaders yung kanyang mga ministry. In verse 19, you can see that the Apostle Paul served the Lord with all humility of mind. We know that the Apostle Paul was exalting no one else but Jesus Christ. Wala na dito yung personal uplifting. And also in verse 19, how did the Apostle Paul serve the Lord? He served the Lord with many tears and temptations or trials. There are times in ministry wherein mapapaiyak ka lang talaga dahil sa mga pinagdadaanan mo. But we have to understand that this is the work of God. And the work of God and doing the will of God is of utmost importance. And because that is the work of God, it is also from God where we could get encouragement and where we could get strength. Even in the case of the Apostle Paul, wherein there were many Jewish people who wanted to kill him. Imaginin mo yung mga kababayan mo na dapat kakampi mo, yung dapat nakaka-relate sa'yo, sila pa yung gustong pumatay sa'yo. So he served the Lord with many tears and trials. And in verse 20, look what the Apostle Paul said there. how I kept back nothing that was profitable unto you. The Apostle Paul ministered to these people by giving them what is profitable to them, what they needed. Nag-serve si Apostle Paul, hindi niya sinubukan na i-appease yung tenga ng mga tao through entertainment. The Apostle Paul did not give them what they wanted, but what they needed. Verse 22, "And now, behold, I go bound in the Spirit unto Jerusalem, not knowing the things that shall befall me there, save that the Holy Ghost witnesseth in every city, saying that bonds and afflictions abide me." Paul did not know exactly what would happen once he comes to Jerusalem. But God had already impressed on him that he would suffer bonds and afflictions. Bonds and afflictions would abide in him. Ikaw kaya, alam mo na kung ano yung idea, may idea ka na kung anong mangyayari sa lugar na pupuntahan mo. Maaring ikamatay mo to, maaring ikakulong mo ito. How did the Apostle Paul respond? Anong sinabi niya sa verse 24? "But none of these things move me, neither count I my life dear unto myself, so that I might finish my course with joy and the ministry which I have received of the Lord Jesus to testify the gospel of the grace of God." Sabi ni Paul, hindi maaari ang mga bagay na to ay makapagpapaalis sa akin or makapag-dissuade sa akin sa paggawa ng gawain ng Diyos. Paul showed that he was totally committed to his course. And this course, this track that he was on, was to serve God. Despite the threats against the life of the Apostle Paul, he was willing to finish his course with joy. Nagagalak siya na kahit mawala ang kanyang buhay ay matapos niya ang pinagagawa sa kanya ng Panginoon with joy. Paul was willing to continually testify the gospel of the grace of God. And this is his ministry. Ito yung natanggap niya mula sa Diyos na ipakita sa mga tao, sa mga Hudyo at sa mga Hentil, ang magandang balita tungkol sa biyaya ng Diyos na ibinigay sa makasalanan sa pamamagitan ni Hesukristo. We can see here a man who is fully committed to the work of God, being a person who has received the grace of God himself. Sino ba si Apostle Paul para iligtas ng Diyos? E persecutor siya ng mga Kristiyano. But he received the saving grace of God. And that is why the Apostle Paul was willing to do the work, to continue the work, despite the numerous things, the numerous problems that are awaiting him. He was determined to continue his ministry of preaching the Lord Jesus Christ. Verse 25, I hope you're still with me. "And now behold," kinakausap again, kinakausap ni Apostle Paul yung mga leaders, nakikinig sa kanya. "And now behold, I know that ye all among whom I have gone preaching the kingdom of God shall see my face no more. Wherefore, I take you to record this day that I am pure from the blood of all men. For I have not shunned to declare unto you all the counsel of God." So Paul continues his conversation with the Ephesian leaders, relating to them how he ministered with them and how he served God with them. Again, Paul gave them the counsel of God. And this is the counsel of God that they would be able to use for edification, for learning about God. And particularly, the Apostle Paul gave them the doctrine which they would eventually use against the false teachers that would infiltrate the church. Verse 28, "Take heed, therefore, unto yourselves." Mag-ingat. "And to all the flock over the which the Holy Ghost hath made you overseers to feed the church of God, which he hath purchased with his own blood. For I know this, that after my departing shall grievous wolves enter in among you, not sparing the flock. Also of your own selves shall men arise, speaking perverse things to draw away disciples after them. Therefore, watch and remember that by the space of 3 years, I ceased not to warn everyone, night and day, with tears. So, the Apostle Paul was exhorting the Ephesian church leaders to take heed of themselves. He calls them to attention of their responsibility being overseers of the church. Sila ito mga nagbabantay sa flock of God. They are what we call as the under-shepherds, with God being the main shepherd. It was their duty to feed the flock, to nourish the flock with the word of God. Kaya sinasabihan niya itong mga church leaders habang kinakausap niya, it is your responsibility to feed the church of God. Because people who preach the word of God, their primary concern is to feed the people with what they need. And that is nourishment from the word of God. Overseers, pastors have the job to nourish the word of God and not to entertain them. Hindi po trabaho ng pastor or ng mga mangangaral ang i-entertain ang mga nakikinig. Hindi trabaho ng mga mangangaral na magpatawa dito para lang makuha ang atensyon ng mga tao at para lang makapagpapunta ng mga tao sa simbahan. Ang kanilang trabaho ay ipangaral ang salita ng Diyos at ibigay kung ano ang kinakailangan ng mga tao para sa kanilang espiritual na buhay. The overseers of the church are not to be mere entertainers or mere life coaches. They are to be proclaimers of the Word of God. Brothers and sisters, as long as the Word of God is faithfully being preached here in the pulpit and applied correctly, do not leave your church. Do not depart from your local church. Do not desert for your local church for a church that you think to be better or providing you what suits your lifestyle or what suits your personality. As long as the word of God is being preached faithfully here in the pulpit and applied, there is no good reason why you should leave. Of course, there are some reasons why you have to transfer to another church, but do not leave your church for superficial reasons. Kung meron mang dahilan kung iiwan mo ang iyong simbahan, eh, kung hindi na pinapangaral ang salita ng Diyos ng totoo dito sa pulpitong ito. So the Apostle Paul was encouraging the overseers of the church, pagpatuloy nyo. He was reminding them of the responsibility to feed the flock of God. Let's continue reading, verse 32. Para po sa mga kasama natin na bago, chapter 20 po tayo ng Acts. Verse 32 says, "And now, brethren, I commend you to God and to the word of His grace, which is able to build you up and to give you an inheritance among all them which are sanctified." So here, makikita natin mga kapatid that Paul is entrusting these elders to God and to the word of His grace. Kung gagamitin natin ang malapit na Filipino term ay ito yung term na ipinagtatagubilin. Ipinagtatagubilin ko kayo sa Diyos at sa salita ng Kanyang biyaya. Iba nakaka-encourage yun kung ang isang pastor o isang missionary ay sinabi sa iyo ay ipinagtatagubilin ko na kayo sa Diyos. Here, makikita natin that God is truly absolutely reliable in caring for His flock. Maaasahan natin ang Diyos na aalagaan ang Kanyang mga tupa. And we have to understand that the Word of God is reliable enough to edify, to nourish the flock, and to give the flock what the flock needs. There are a lot of people, a lot of churches who are concerned in maintaining the huge number of their membership, the huge number of their attendance by resorting to gimmicks, by resorting to entertainment. But this is not how the church of God has to be sustained, has to be nourished. Entertainment and gimmicks, yes, they have their appeal. But these things would not give the people what they need for their spiritual lives. Eh ano ngayon kung natawa tayo sa joke ng preacher? Ano ngayon kung natuwa tayo dahil magaling siya magsalita? Kung ang preacher ay hindi nagbibigay ng salita ng Diyos at hindi pinapangaral ang salita ng Diyos na kinakailangan natin, walang nourishment na mangyayari sa atin. Hindi tayo lalago spiritually. And that is why Paul was entrusting the people. I entrust you to God. I commend you to God and the word of His grace. Mga kapatid, maging dependent tayo sa salita ng Diyos dahil ito ang magiging nourishment sa atin. Verse 33, I have coveted no man's silver or gold or apparel. Yea, ye yourselves know that these hands have ministered unto my necessities and to them that were with me. I have showed you all things, how that so laboring you ought to support the weak. And to remember the words of the Lord Jesus, how He said, it is more blessed to give than to receive. Ministers, preachers, we know that we serve here in church not for profit. Kaya tayo nagsasamba, kaya tayo nangangaral ng salita ng Diyos, ay hindi natin, dahil hindi natin gusto kumita or magpayaman. Although, this ministry of preaching the Word of God is being abused in many places. Kung saan marami mga tao, mas concerned sila sa love gift na makukuha nila, concerned sila sa giving ng mga tao dahil sila ay may parte doon sa giving na yon. But here, the Apostle Paul is showing the people that that was not his intent. Hindi intent ni Apostle Paul na magpayaman lamang. And kung babalikan natin lahat ng sinasabi niya, it was really his desire to feed the church of God with the word of God. Dahil mahal na mahal niya itong mga mananampalataya na to. Mahal na mahal niya itong mga mananampalataya na to na dati ay kinamumuhian niya. But because of the grace of God that worked through the life of the Apostle Paul, sobrang mahal niya sila. And he was willing to serve them even though he would not gain any profit from them. How did the Apostle Paul sustain himself? He continued to serve by working. Kaya hindi po pwede na tatamad-tamad ka at mag-expect ka na paparami ka ng pera. Ministers are not to covet wealth. Kung ikaw ay nagmi-ministro, hindi ka dapat naghahangad ng malaking pera. Laboring to satisfy one's necessities is very important. The church also has to continue supporting the weak as the Apostle Paul here has given a bit of emphasis. Kinakailangan natin na suportahan yung mga tao na nangangailangan. The weak, not the lazy. Now, let's continue reading. Verse 36, and when he had thus spoken, si Apostle Paul, he kneeled down and prayed with them all. And they all wept sore and fell on the apostle's neck and kissed him, sorrowing most of all for the words which he spake, that they should see his face no more, and they accompanied him unto the ship. So, the Apostle Paul was again talking to the Ephesian leaders. And after he was done giving them these exhortations, these encouraging words, these words of admonition and exhortation, anong ginawa nila? Nag-pray sila, nag-iyakan sila, they kneeled down, pray with them, and they all wept sore and fell on Paul's neck and kissed him. Maaring halo-halo na yung kanilang mga emosyon dito kung bakit sila naiiyak. Maaring may mga umiiyak dahil hindi na nila makikita ang kanilang minamahal na ministro. Maaring may mga naiiyak dito dahil sa kabigatan ng responsibility na pinaalala sa kanila ni Apostle Paul bilang mga ministro ng Church of God. At maaring hindi natin alam kung ano yung exactly na experience nila, pero makikita natin dito sa picture na to, particularly sa verses 36 to 38, ang pagmamahalan ng mga mananampalataya sa isa't isa. They really, really love each other. Grabe ang pagmamahal ng mga mananampalataya sa isa't isa to the point na nag-iiyakan sila knowing that they would not see each other again. And this is the last time that the Apostle Paul would able to talk to them in such way. Based on the truths and principles that we have read in the entire chapter 20, what are some things that we can apply? Well, mga kapatid, the focal idea that we would like to highlight here is that Christ's love for His church should compel us to love and care for His church. Christ's love for His church should compel us to love and care for His church. How do we apply the narrative that we have read? Our application is very simple. Let us commend the church to God and to His Word. Let us commend the church to God and to His Word. The Apostle Paul, in this speech to the Ephesian church leaders, showed his genuine love for them. Grabe ang kanyang pagmamahal, hindi lang sa mga elders, kundi pati sa church na kanilang inaalagaan, kundi pati sa mga miyembro na kanilang inaalagaan. And why was the Apostle Paul loving this church so much? Because this is the people whom Christ died for. These are the same people who received the same saving grace of God that the Apostle Paul also received. And that is why we who are members of the Church of God, particularly Baptist Bible Church, we are also to express the same love for our brethren who have received the grace of God as ourselves. Do you care for your fellow church members? Do you care for your preachers, your teachers, your deacons? Meron po ba tayong pagmamahal sa ating mga kapwa mananampalataya? We know that God is truly worthy to be entrusted with His church. Alam natin yun, na mapagkakatiwalaan natin ang Diyos para alagaan ang kanyang simbahan. But a lot of times, there is a problem with us wherein we stop caring for the church. Na tila ba wala na tayong pakialam sa simbahan to the point na kahit hindi natin sila makita ng isang taon, eh wala tayong pakialam. To the point na we are not eager to go to church every Sunday because we do not care for the church. We do not care for the responsibility of the church members to edify one another. But let us remember again how Christ showed His love for the church. How Christ showed His love for you and to the rest of His church. And it is through this picture that we would get to be motivated to love the church as well. Kaya nga sabi dun sa Ephesians 5:25, para dun sa mga mag-asawa, di ba? Anong sabi sa Ephesians 5:25? Husbands, love your wives. As Christ loved the church that He gave Himself for it. Do you love your church? Again, that's my question. Do you still pray for your church? The Apostle Paul said, I commend you to God and to the word of His grace. So whenever we are reminded to pray, we are also to pray for our church. When was the last time that you prayed for your church? 1 Thessalonians 5:17 says, pray without ceasing. Diba? Are we following that command? So when we pray, one of the things that we can pray for is the church. We can pray for faithfulness in the proclamation of the Word of God. Maaari itatanong nyo sa bawat isa, tatanong nyo sa sarili nyo, paano ko mapagpipray yung church ko? You can pray for the faithful proclamation of the Word of God, especially here in this pulpit. Many church attenders around the world, particularly in mega churches, they are seeking entertainment from the pulpit more than they seek the Word of God. And it is sad that even Baptist churches provide more hours of entertainment, more hours of jokes, more hours of acrobatics than the exposition of the Word of God. Paano umabot sa punto na ganun? It's because people started to crave for different things aside from the Word of God. At itong mga ministro nila, ang problema is they give in. The ministers would give in to their demands. Ay, hindi magugustuhan kasi ng mga tao, ng mga audience, yung salit, if I would expose the Word of God and help them apply the Word of God, hindi magugustuhan ng mga tao yun. Baka makatulog yung mga tao. Or baka hindi mag-attend yung mga tao, baka magsilipatan sa ibang churches. Wag na lang. I would just try to provide entertainment for them. But let us remember what the Apostle Paul said. He gave to the church what was beneficial. He did not hide from them what was beneficial to them. And that is why he proclaimed the whole counsel of God to them. He proclaimed the word of God, the word of His grace, the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Paul did not shy away from telling the Jewish people and the people in different parts of that region na sinasamba at ibang-ibang Diyos, harap-harapan sinasabi niya, repent and turn to God. Repent toward God and profess faith on the Lord Jesus Christ. Even though he knew that the people would be angry against him, that his fellow countrymen would be angry against him, the message that the Apostle Paul held and proclaimed is the truth. And that is why he preached it wholeheartedly. This is what the people need right now. The preaching of the gospel. A lot of people spend their weeks, pagod na pagod sila sa trabaho, and then once they end up in church, ano ipapakain ng ministro sa kanila? entertainment. Nagdadala pa ng clowns, ng mga kung ano-ano pagsasayaw sa pulpito, sa stage, para lang matuwa ang mga tao. But that is what, not what the people need. What the people need is the gospel and the word of God that relates to the gospel. Kaya kung nakikinig po kayo at maaring naboboringan kayo or nagugulat kayo, nagugulantang kayo sa mga ginagawa dito sa church namin, I invite you to believe the gospel. The Bible tells us that we have all sinned against God. And we, because of our sins, could not save ourselves. Nagkasala tayo laban sa Diyos. At dahil hindi natin kayang mailigtas ang ating sarili, ay kinakailangan natin ng isang tao na kaya tayong iligtas mula sa ating problema. At walang iba iyon kundi si Jesucristo. John 3:16 tells us, "For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him," kung sino man ang nakay Kristo, "whosoever believeth in Him should not perish but have everlasting life." I invite you, as the Apostle Paul has said, repent toward God and profess faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Stop trusting your own self for your own salvation because you could not save yourself. You are standing condemned and punishable before a God who is holy. But Jesus Christ died on the cross to pay for the sins of sinners. If you profess your faith in Him, you can be sure that you are forgiven. If your faith is on, genuinely on Jesus Christ. So kung hindi nyo pa po yun nagagawa, I invite you to do so. That is the message that we preach here in the pulpit. The gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Kung umabot po sa punto na yung mga tumatayo dito ay puro jokes na lang, puro entertainment na lang, puro self-help na lang, that person is, pwede nyo siyang kausapin. Bakit yan ang pinipreach mo? Just preach the word of God. Even if one of us start doing so, pwede nyo kaming kausapin regarding that. 2 Timothy 4:2 tells us, "Preach the word. Be instant in season, out of season. Reprove, rebuke, exhort with all suffering and doctrine." The Apostle Paul gave that verse particularly for Timothy. Preach the word, be instant in season, out of season. Kahit hindi gusto ng mga tao yan, yan ang kanilang kailangan. Ang salita ng Diyos. Church, let us hold each preacher here in this pulpit and even the teachers in our ministries accountable for proclaiming nothing else but the Word of God. We do not preach here. We do not endorse products. We do not endorse politicians. We only endorse the Word of God. And that is why the Word of God has to be preached faithfully. You can ask whenever you're listening to a preaching, is the Word of God being preached faithfully? Is it being preached in its right context? Is the preaching pointing to Jesus Christ more than it points to the people? More than it points to the person who is preaching? Marami mga tao, kapag nagpipreach sila, mas madami pa yung kanilang life testimony. So the preaching must be preached faithfully. Must preach the Word of God faithfully. The preaching must be Christ-ward. And the preaching must also preach passionately. This is an encouragement for those, especially young men who are preaching, and even teachers. When you are giving the word of God to the people, do it passionately. Hindi yung parang nagdududa kayo sa ginagawa nyo. Hindi naman kaduda-duda ang salita ng Diyos, tama po ba? So we have to preach the word of God and teach the word of God with passion. Hindi yung parang hindi kayo sigurado kung ano yung sinasabi nyo. And another thing, we can preach the Word of God understandably. That is why sermon preparation is very tedious. Hindi po biro na kahit mag-devotion lang, alam na mga men yan sa choir, and even yung mga nagpipreach sa saya, hindi po biro ang mag-prepare ng salita ng Diyos. Dahil hindi lang naman po kami umaakyat dito at sinasabi, ano kayang sasabihin ng banal na Espiritu through me? And then walang preparation, walang pag-aaral ng salita ng Diyos. There is the demand to preach the Word of God so that in a way that people will be able to understand. Of course, the Holy Spirit is the one who will teach the people, but the preacher must also take time to make sure that he is communicating effectively the Word of God. How can you pray for the church? How else? Let us pray for the submission of the church to the Word of God. And this is our last point here. Pray for the submission of the church to the Word of God. Baptist Bible Church. We are a Baptist church and we are a Bible church. And that is why we rely on the Bible as our final and ultimate authority when it comes to faith and when it comes to practice. Anything else that contradicts the Word of God must be set aside. Hindi po ito ang magpapatakbo sa ating mga buhay bilang mga mananampalataya. Ang salita ng Diyos lang ang magpapatakbo sa ating pag-iisip at sa ating mga ginagawa. Kung babalikan natin yung isa sa mga verses, and I hope you have already memorized this dahil lagi natin binabalikan. 2 Timothy 3, chapter 3, verses 16 to 17. All scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness. That the man of God may be thoroughly perfect, that the man of God may be perfect, thoroughly furnished unto every good work. Sabi nga doon sa isa sa preaching natin last Sunday, sabi ng isa sa mga preacher, pinoint out niya yung Psalm 119:105, "Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path." Why is there so much confusion in the world right now? Why is there much confusion regarding the truth? There are many truth claims that are bombarding our ears. Alin dito ang katotohanan? Naguguluhan ng mga tao. Kung alin ba ang totoong turo? There is the Word of God, which is our final authority, which is our guide as believers. The Word of God must be given importance here in this church, the preaching and the teaching of the Word of God, more than the other things that we do. Because this Word of God is what we have to submit to. By the Word of God, we get to know who God is. You could not imagine God based on your own imaginations alone. Baka kung ano-ano pa ma-imagine mo dyan. You might end up like the people who are worshiping Artemis, Diana, or the other gods and goddesses that we have encountered recently. You could not just imagine God and treat Him like that, your imagination. The Bible tells us who God is, and we must acknowledge the characteristics of God, as the Bible says, whether we like these things or not. We get to know who God is by reading the Word of God, and at the same time, we get to know what He likes, what He desires, and what He hates. We abstain from what He hates, and we obey what He desires. By the Word of God, we get to know the privileges that we have in Christ. Tayo bilang mga mananampalataya sa mundong ito, huwag tayo maawa sa ating sarili. Dahil tayo ay na kay Kristo at napakaraming privilege na nakukuha tayo mula sa Diyos through Jesus Christ, na hindi nakukuha ng mundo. By the Word of God, we will be edified and we will be encouraged. How's your Bible reading, mga kapatid? How's your Bible study? How's your personal devotion? Kung hindi nyo nga nagagawa, magtipon-tipon, makipagtipon sa kapwa mananampalataya. How much more yung personal devotion nyo? By the Word of God, we will be edified and encouraged. And by the Word of God, we get to identify the false doctrines and be able to avoid them. Napakaraming maling katuruan na kumakalat, especially in this world of fast communication. Yung video na in-upload mula sa isang lugar na napakalayo, pwede mo mapanood instantly. And what if these things are erroneous? What if these things are false doctrines? Paano nyo malalaman? Eventually, papasok yan sa church and many people would start believing such false doctrines. Paano nyo malalaman yung false doctrines? Eh, hindi nga tayo nag-aaral ng salita ng Diyos. So, we have to study the Word of God. Brothers and sisters, we do not gather here for mere entertainment. Because if we are gathering here just for entertainment, then we are doing a bad job. Kasi hindi naman kami nakakatawa. Hindi naman kami entertaining eh. That's not our job. We do not gather for amusement or entertainment because there are other places for that. Kung nag-expect kayo na pumunta sa church para lang patuwain ang inyong sarili at patawanin ang inyong sarili, maraming mga ano dyan, madaming ibang lugar na pwede kayong puntahan. But we gather together as a church so that we as His children would worship God together. Can you worship God together kung magsosolo kayo sa sarili niyong mga bahay? We gather together so that we as His children could worship God together and together learn from the Word of God. Yes? When we gather together, sometimes nakakatulog tayo, falling asleep, might be unavoidable. Maaring puyat yung iba sa inyo, maaring yung iba sa inyo ay gumising na sobrang aga, or may sakit, di natin alam. Okay? Hindi ko naman ginajudge yung mga natutulog sa inyo. Okay? Pero there are times na nakakatulog tayo. But we have to understand what's wrong. What's wrong with our hearts? Bakit hindi tayo interested? If we are not interested in listening to the Word of God. Ayokong gamitin si Eutychus as an example na baka matulad tayo. Di ba? But we have always to exhort effort to learn from the Word of God. Again, yung preachers and teachers natin, you have to strive to preach the Word of God faithfully and communicate it effectively para hindi rin naman makatulog yung mga tao. Okay? And yung mga tao na nakikinig, pinaghirapan po to ng mga ministro natin. So, kinakailangan din natin mag-exert ng effort na magkaroon ng desire na matutunan ang salita ng Diyos. At hindi lang matutunan para din tayo ay mag-submit dito. So as we close, do you love the church enough to pray for it? Can you pray for your church? Do you love your church? Mahal niyo po ba ang Baptist Bible Church or tuwing anniversary lang? Diba? Love your church, that means loving the people that are in your church. The Apostle Paul loved the church so much that he shed tears for its sake. And the church loved him back. They ministered together under the work of God. Ganun yung pagmamahala nila sa isa't isa. The Apostle Paul was always praying for them. And now that he knows, that he has an idea what could happen to him, that he could die, iyan ang binili niya. Pinagtatagubilin ko kayo sa Diyos. As he has always had. So let us love our church. Whenever we are having a hard time loving our church, tingnan yung mga katabi nyo, yung mga tao sa likod nyo. Mahal nyo po ba sila? Yeah? Whenever you're having a hard time loving your church or praying for your church, remember what Jesus Christ has done on the cross for the church. As the world focuses on the love for each other, wala namang problema dyan. Let us focus primarily on the love of Jesus Christ that He has shown. We will continue our lesson next week as we continue the life of the Apostle Paul. If you could read in advance chapter 21 and chapter 22, that could help us as we discuss the lesson next week. May I request everyone to please stand? Magsitayo po tayong lahat as we close in a word of prayer. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for the important truths that you have imparted through your word. And we thank you, Lord, for the Holy Spirit for teaching us what we need to learn. Help us, Lord, to love your church, to value your word, and to entrust ourselves to you. We ask, Lord, that you continually to encourage us and motivate us to love your word. And by loving your word, we will get to know you more and know what you desire and what you hate so that we would be able to live lives that are pleasing to no other else but our God, the God who has provided salvation to us. Bless the members, Lord, who are listening. If there is anyone who has listened to this lesson who has not yet professed faith on your Son, Jesus Christ, we ask, Lord, for the Holy Spirit to convict that heart of the person so that that person would be able to profess faith on Jesus Christ. All these things I pray in the name of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen.